Welcome back, you're watching Storyboard. After announcing the merger of J. Walter Thompson with Wunderman in last November, WPP has finally made it official and announced a new brand identity for their new agency, Wunderman Thompson. Storyboard's Ankita Saxena caught up with Tarun Rai, Chairman and CEO South Asia, Wunderman Thompson, and spoke to him about what this merger means for both clients and employees. Take a look.
Hello, Tarun. Welcome to CNBC TV 18.
Glad to be here.
Tarun, sometime in December last year, this whole merger of Wunderman and J. Walter Thompson was announced. And now it's finally on the books. And recently, WPP also rolled out the new brand identity. So what led to this merger? What was the rationale behind it?
Well, firstly, it's a very exciting time for us. After the rollout of the new brand identity of Wunderman Thompson in New York on 4th of February, India and South Asia, our region, is only the second region in anywhere in the world to roll out this identity. And we rolled it out just a couple of days ago. So it is really exciting time for us. And I think the reason and the raison d'etre of this merger is actually led by what clients are asking for. And increasingly, a lot of the clients that we are working with are looking for an end-to-end solution which is well integrated, which is seamless, and which is simple. And I think the merger of Wunderman's capabilities along with the capabilities of J. Walter Thompson are in a position to deliver exactly that. So we are an organization which is based on creativity, data, and technology to inspire growth for ambitious brands.
So do you think this merger holds a mirror to the ethos of advertising today? Because, you know, this chatter has been there for quite some time that, you know, clients want end-to-end solutions. They want things simplified. Yep. They don't want complexity. What's your take on that?
Well, I think that we are setting up with this merger a precedent for our entire industry, especially in our region here. And I think that we are a new breed of agency, a breed of agency which has got the capability. And I think one of the most important things for us is the ability to attract talent, to attract diverse talent. Otherwise, what we were finding was that there were certain kind of people who wanted to work in the so-called traditional agencies, but there were a lot of other people who wanted to work for digital agencies.
Okay.
Now, we have got a situation with Wunderman Thompson. You have got data, you've got technology, you've got brand building, you have got an ethos and a culture which likes and promotes diversity, which is based on growth. So to me, our ability to attract talent also goes up substantially. And I think, as I said, it's a new breed of agency, and it's a place where a lot of people are going to build their careers, and it's inspiring growth, not just for our clients' brands, but also for our own people.
Yeah. You just mentioned the new breed of agency. You know, with so much of media fragmentation and traditional agencies, media agencies and tech companies stepping and eating into each other's turf, and, you know, is this the death knell for the traditional ad agency? And do you think it will give way to a new era of a more consolidated and a more comprehensive agency and business model? You know, there have been examples within WPP, you know, with MEC and Maxis turning into Wavemaker. Then there's YML, YNR, and now Wunderman Thompson.
See, I can't say when we are going to hear the death knell of the traditional agency. But to me, whether it's a death knell soon or later is not the important thing. What is important is that if agencies don't change, we are going to become dinosaurs. And you know what happened to the dinosaurs. I think it's about agencies missing out, or traditional agencies missing out on opportunities which the ecosystem and technology offers today. So therefore, forget the death knell. It may come, it came come a couple of years later. But the important thing is that if we don't change, then we are going to get marginalized, which is why I keep saying that, you know, look at it from a positive point of view. Rather than get marginalized, may as well change, and change quickly.
Okay. Coming back to Wunderman Thompson, how will this consolidation, this integration pan out, you know, in terms of hierarchy, in terms of logistics? What are you looking forward to?
Well, I'm really looking forward to growth and aggressive growth. Aggressive growth for, as I said, our clients, their brands, and aggressive growth for our people's careers. Yeah. So that is the overall objective. But for that, we have to first integrate well, integrate people into our organization as a whole, from Wunderman and from J. Walter Thompson, integrate the capabilities, because as I said, clients are looking for a seamless integration, which we can bring under one roof. We have to build a strong culture, and that culture is going to be a culture which is focused on growth, which is focused on ambition, which is focused on delivering the best work that we can.
Okay, so what will be your key focus areas? Will it be research? Will it be content? Will it be data, technology, talent acquisition? What will be your key focus areas?
Well, talent acquisition, as I said, is an ongoing thing. And I think with Wunderman and Thompson coming together to actually make Wunderman Thompson, we will be able to attract diverse talent, talent that we always want within our organization. So talent continues to be a top priority for us. But beyond that, as I said, we have to make sure that we can deliver the seamless integrated solution for our clients end to end.
You mentioned that talent acquisition is an ongoing process, but you know, it is also right now the most pressing issue in the industry in general.
Yeah.
How will you retain and acquire new talent, and more so now with Wunderman Thompson coming into place? Do you think that specialization is the need of the hour?
Specialization is the need of the hour, but as I said, clients want specialization, but they also want integration. So if Wunderman Thompson can offer the clients one team, as we say, one client, one team to deliver brand thinking all the way down to customer engagement. If we can deliver that, we will also be attracting the kind of talent that has the ability to deliver that. Within one organization, we will have a bunch of specialized people.
Advertising and media predictions for this year, for 2019, are out. GroupM has come out with its report, and so has Madison. And the advertising and media investment growth is pegged at around 14 to 16% this year. I met Stephen Allen of MediaCom recently, and he said that he's very bullish about the Indian market, and it's an exciting year for India, especially with the elections coming in. So how will you leverage this great Indian opportunity right now?
Yeah, I agree with you. India is the place to be in the world today. And at 14% growth with the much, much bigger base that we have now as compared to a few years ago, I think it's fantastic. The other interesting thing about these media reports, and something that we recognize, is all media is growing. Yes, digital is growing at 30%, but even television is growing at 15%.
True.
Print is growing.
Yeah.
You know, we are talking earlier about death knell of traditional agencies. Yeah. Well, we don't know. You know, 70% of ad spending, according to these reports, in the country is still with traditional media of television and print.
True.
From our point of view, if we are a company which is Wunderman Thompson, if we are have the ability to deliver television as well as e-commerce, we are in a sweet spot.
Okay, so if you had to make a pitch to a client right now, what would it be?
As I said, which client won't want long-term brand building based on data, which gives us great insights all the way to the last mile, to consumer engagement, to e-commerce, on technology, all under one roof?
All right, Tarun, thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you very much. Great talking to you.
It is time for us to take a short break. On the other side of this break, we speak to James Munson, Managing Director of Marks & Spencer's India, and speak to him about what is making this brand rethink.